Welcome to the video news of the week. This past week, the annual Lancaster Fair was held. The Chronicle was there on Friday for some music, livestock, and fairtime action.
The New Hampshire state primary election is next Tuesday, September 13th. Candidates will be chosen for their respective parties and will then square off against each other in the general election, which is November 8th. This week, the Chronicle compiled a list of the names voters will be seeing on their ballots for next week's primary. You can see the full listing in this week's Colebrook Chronicle. The Chronicle recently spoke with Dana Hilliard, who was campaigning for the position of executive counselor for District 1. He is expecting to challenge incumbent Councillor Joe Kenny in November. During our interview with Hilliard, he spoke about the District 1 region he would be covering.
It's a vast amount of land, but the great thing that under this new districting and configuration is that the story and history of the majority of District 1 is the same. It was communities that had their height during the Industrial Revolution, that then were able to survive when the shoe shop industry opened up and manufacturing was still strong within New Hampshire, and then communities that had to find their way when those industries ultimately blown out, and re-get back to what their roots of history were so that they could determine what that next course of path of their success was going to be. The Executive Council is extremely important when it comes to New Hampshire governing. As the Executive Council approves any state contract over $10,000, so let's just say they approve pretty much all state contracts, and then any appointment that the governor brings forward is confirmed by the Executive Council. So now we are talking about all boards and commissions and anyone who is going to serve in the capacity of running one of the state departments. You know, we love to pride ourselves in New Hampshire on local control, but know that that barely exists. And it barely exists because local control exists at paying the bill at the local level, but not getting the support from Concord. You know, and it is imperative that we have executive counselors that will approve state contracts that help support the local cities and towns.
You can read the full interview with Hilliard in this week's Colebrook Chronicle.
Over the weekend, the Colebrook Chronicle's traveling camera was on the road as we attended the 30th annual New World Festival in Randolph, Vermont. The one-day festival features leading Celtic and Francophone performers. A highlight came at the end of the night when two former band members of the legendary Irish-American band Solace were reunited on stage. Guitarist, vocalist John Doyle, who performs today with the group The Alt, invited fellow former Solace member Karan Casey on stage for a memorable number together.
Thank you.
Expect mostly clear skies for the weekend. Friday reaches a high of 79 degrees. Saturday climbs to a high of 82 with a low of 56. And Sunday temps range from a high of 80 to a low of 59. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.